Port Adelaide has defended the position of the Magpies in the SANFL as pressure builds from other clubs for a reduced 8-team competition. TEN's Ian Shuttleworth joins us from Alberton with more on the story he broke for us last night. Shuts.
Beck, it continues to be a significant talking point around the local league, and by that I mean dropping one of the teams, or one of the 9 teams, for the start of the 2014 season, and much of that focus has fallen right here at Alberton.
Few sporting teams have enjoyed success like the Port Magpies, although it hasn't stopped their place in the SANFL being questioned. Several club administrators have told 10 News a 9-team competition is no longer viable. They firmly believe one club must go. The Port faithful outraged.
I'd be shattered.
Nobody would be that silly, surely. Wouldn't happen.
We were like one of the oldest teams in the SANFL. I mean, gee, come on, you know, it's been unfair.
The dropping of a team, and in particular the Magpies, was discussed at a recent meeting of high-ranking officials. Their reasons? It would give Port's struggling AFL team a greater chance of off-field success, avoid the confusion of Port fielding 2 teams with different jumpers, as well as doing away with the bye in the local league. Minutes of that meeting leaked to 10 News and sent to the SA Football Commissioner's state. The workshop identified a number of strengths and weaknesses of an 8- and 9-team competition. On the basis of this discussion, we agreed to request the Commission to conduct a more formal review of the optimum competition size. Their concerns further highlighted by the Sturt Football Club being asked to front its landlord, the Unley City Council, to explain its perilous financial position. However, SANFL boss Lee Wicker has told 10 News any change to 8 teams is not as high a priority as the move to a redeveloped Adelaide Oval and possible changes to the Crows and Power licences.
The Port Adelaide Football Club did release a statement just a short time ago. It comes from their chief executive, Keith Thomas, and he says that from Port's point of view, let me state our absolute support for the Magpies. He goes on to say that they've been a tremendously valuable asset to the Port Adelaide Football Club, as well as football in South Australia. And he says it's been that way for a very long time and remains the case. But Beck, some very interesting times await in the SANFL.
Thanks very much, Shantz.